In this video, I'm going to work through the solution to an engineering mechanics rigid body equilibrium problem. Okay, let's start by reading through and understanding the question. So we've got a diagram over here and some information over here. So we're told that what we're looking at is part of a mechanism, and the component that we're particularly interested is this component labeled A, B, C, D. So we've got A to B to C to D, so this is all one component. And we're told that it's loaded by a 500 newton meter couple at B, so we can see that over here. So let's just highlight that in our questions. And we're also told that we have a 550 newton force at D, which we can see here. So again, let's highlight that bit of information. And we're also told that the component is connected to the rest of the system, or the rest of the mechanism, which is not shown. Okay, so we just, in our diagram, we've got our component here, part of some sort of mechanism, and then out here where this connection is to some other parts of a mechanism or structure, and we've got these representations of that connection. So we have a pin joint at A. So we've got that by a pin joint at A, and we have a roller support at C. Okay, so here this represents a roller support. So we'll need that information for when we're drawing our free body diagram. Okay, and we're asked to determine the magnitude of the reaction forces on the component at the supports. And we can also take note here that the dimensions that we have on our diagram are in millimeters. Okay, so the first part of our solution to an engineering mechanics equilibrium problem is to draw a free body diagram. Okay, so that can be just a simple representation of the external boundaries of the component that we're analyzing. So in this case, fairly simple. All right, once we've done that, we can start to put on some dimensions just for reference, and also label the points where we're going to reference when we do our solution. Okay, so just put on points A, B, C, and D, so we can use those to reference where the forces and moments and supports are. Okay, so when we draw the free body diagram, it's important that we remove the other components that are attached to it. Okay, so our supports here, we should remove those from our free body diagram. Okay, because what we're doing in drawing the free body diagram is to say, what force does this component here apply to the component A, B, C, D that we're analyzing? Okay, so if they're still connected, then there's at C equal and opposite forces in there. Okay, so we draw our free body diagram without those supports in place. Okay, so we're drawing in here the forces that are that the supports provide on the body that we're analyzing. Okay, so what force do these components here apply to the component A, B, C, D that we're analyzing? All right, so let's start by putting on the forces that we know. So they're our loads that are given in the question. So we have our 550 newton force here acting at 30 degrees to the vertical. And we also have a moment applied at B. So we put that in as well. And then we can start to consider the forces applied to the beam by the supports. Okay, so let's start by looking at the support at C. So we're told that this is a roller support, which means that it can move freely in the horizontal direction here, so freely in the direction of that surface, but provides a constraint, right, stops this component from moving in the vertical direction. So on our free body diagram, we'll just have a single force in the vertical direction to represent that constraint that's applied to the component ABCD. And we should also label that, so we've just called that here R subscript C. So the next thing to look at is the force at A. So if we go back up to our free body our original diagram, we've got a pin connection here, which means that the component ABCD is constrained from moving both vertically and horizontally, so we'll need forces in the vertical and horizontal direction to represent that constraint, but it's free to rotate about point A. Okay, so there's no moment reaction at A. So let's put those forces in, and so I've just assumed a sense for these forces. Doesn't matter if you get them incorrect. What will happen is that when you do your algebra in your solving of equations, if the force here is actually acting downwards, then the answer you get will be negative. So we should also put on here now some labels for our forces. So we're looking for forces at A, so we'll call that reaction, capital R, subscript A, for the reaction at A, subscript Y, for the Y direction. And now that we've used X and Y components, we should also indicate what those components are in terms of a coordinate system. So we have X and Y indicated here, so X positive to the right, Y positive upwards, and we also have in it anti-clockwise as positive for our moments. Okay, so now that we have our free body diagram, we can go and start to write some equations of equilibrium. Right, so I've just gone to a new page here. You can just continue following on your larger piece of paper in your solution. Okay, so the first equation of equilibrium that we'll use will be a moment equation, because we can usually find a point on our body that we're analyzing where we can remove some of the unknowns from the equation. So in this case, if we take moments about point A here, RAX will pass through point A, RAY will also pass through point A, so they'll have a zero moment about point A. And our only other known, only other unknown in the system is RC, subscript C. So, and that is acting at a distance of 300 from point A, so we know that will have a moment, so we should be able to find that out straight away. So note that when you write this moment equation, it's very important that you indicate here the point about which you're calculating moments. Okay, without that, you or anybody else can't go back and check that you've written your moment equation correctly or not. Okay, so let's work our way through our loads that are applied here and work out their moment effect. So the first one, we'll just add the moment effect of the applied couple. And so that's 500 newton meters, and it's going in the clockwise direction. Clockwise direction. So therefore, it's a negative moment according to our assumed anti-clockwise as positive system. So then we can move along and look at the force RC. Okay, so that force is acting up here at a perpendicular distance of 300 from point A, and because our moment is in newton meters, and we just put that into our equation here, we need to convert the 300 millimeters into meters. So that will be RC times 0.3, and we can see that that will be rotating the component anti-clockwise about point A, so that will be a positive moment. Okay, so now we move along to the force at the end here. Now this force will have vertical and horizontal components, okay, which are both at a distance away from point A. So we're going to have two terms from in the moment equation from this single force here, right? Unless you want to go and try and find out the perpendicular distance of this force at 30 degrees from point A. Okay, so let's start by considering the vertical component. So that will be 550 cos 30 acting down here, which is at 800 millimeters perpendicular distance from point A. So let's write that in. So 550 cos 30 times 0.8 for converting it to meters. And that will be acting down here and tending to rotate the component clockwise about point A. Okay, so around this way, so therefore a negative moment. And then we also need the horizontal component of the 550, right, because that acts at a distance of 400 from point A. So we need to add that in as well. So 550 sine 30 times 0.4, and that is also going clockwise about point A. So that's also a negative moment. And that, of course, is all equal to zero. So we need to put that at the end there. All right, so we now have one equation with only RC as an unknown. So let's do the algebra and calculate what RC is. And in this case, it's 3303.5 newtons. Okay, so now that we have that, we can start to apply our other equations of equilibrium. So let's do sum of the forces in the horizontal direction equals zero. So in this case, we only have RAX and the horizontal component of the 550 newton force. So we can just write in there straight away, RAX equals 550 sine 30, and solve for that and get 275 newtons. And then our next equation of equilibrium is sum of the forces in the vertical direction equals zero. So we'll have RAY plus RC, both in the positive direction, minus the vertical component of the 550 newton force, so minus 550 cos 30. All equal to zero. We can substitute in RC and do the algebra and solve for RAY. So now we have the components for RA in the x direction and in the y direction. In the question, we were asked for the magnitude of the reaction forces. So we now need to apply Pythagoras rule, so square root of the sum of the squares, to get our resultant force at the pin support at A, which in this case is 2840.5 newtons. And finally, we should summarize our answers. So we'll write final answers at the end and also round our answers up to appropriate number of significant figures, usually three. So we have RA equals 2.84 kilonewtons, and the force RC at the roller support C is 3.30 kilonewtons. Okay, so that's it. Thanks for listening. I hope this was helpful. See you next time.